Question 14. I am thinking of a number that is not zero. I multiply my number by negative 5. Tick the statement below that is true. Well, we've got three statements. Either the answer must be positive, the answer must be negative, or the answer could be either positive or negative. And we've got to explain it. Well, if the number is not zero, it can be either positive or negative. They're the only things that aren't zero, because zero is neither positive nor negative. And we've got to multiply either a positive number by negative 5, or we've got to do a negative number times by negative 5. So let's do a few examples of both. Well, a positive number times negative 5, we could do 3 lots of negative 5, which would be negative 15. We could do 4 lots of negative 5, which would be negative 20. We could even do 10 lots of negative 5, which would be negative 50. Now, if you look at all of our answers, all of these answers are negative. So it seems that when we do a positive number times a negative number, positive times a negative, we get a negative answer, as shown by these answers here. So a positive times a negative gives a negative answer. So it shows that the answer could be negative. Now let's look at what happens if we do a negative number times by negative 5. Well, we could do negative 3 times negative 5. Well, 3 times 5 is 15, but when both numbers are negative, a negative times a negative gives you a positive answer. Two negatives makes a positive, so it's a positive 15. We could do negative 4 times by negative 5. Well, 4 fives are 20, but two negatives make a positive, so it's positive 20. So if we inspect these two answers, we can see that these two answers are both positive. So the conclusion we've got to draw from this, that a negative number times another negative number gives us a positive answer. Now we're almost ready to tick our box. Tick the statement that is true. Well, as long as we're not multiplying by zero, we could be doing any of these statements, or we could be doing any of these. And the answers that we have got are either negative or positive. So we've got some negative answers and some positive answers, therefore the answer could be positive or negative. So that's the one we've got to tick. If we tick either of the other two, it's got to be wrong. But we've got to do some sort of explanation. And the easiest way of explaining it is to say this. We could say, we could do positive times negative, which would give a negative answer, or a negative times by a negative, which would give a positive answer. Remember, these negatives here are the negative 5 that we're trying to do. So we could just pop negative 5 over there. So a positive number times negative 5 would be negative, and a negative number times negative 5 would be positive. Therefore, the answer could be positive or negative. And that's your explanation. And that's the final question on the paper. So it was always going to be quite a difficult one, but it is level 6, and if you've done that question, you've earned some really good marks there. You should be proud of yourself. Well done.